This is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. Today I have a very special treat for you. I'm on another field trip. I'm out here in Las Vegas, Nevada for a trade show. And one of the things I like to do when I'm traveling is to visit farms and nurseries and find out what's growing in different areas. So today we're at Gilcrease Orchard on this big, watering truck or some industrial tool. It's really cool. This is a U-Pick farm, so you could come here and pick your own produce for really cheap. So if you live in Las Vegas, there's no excuse why you shouldn't come here. And it's also really cool to see what they're growing and how they're growing it. Let's come inside and check it out.
So I often like to look at what farms are doing in commercial farms like Gilcrease to see what really works. Hopefully they've researched it and grown these same crops year after year because they know they do well in this desert climate and environment. And so today what they're growing is Sweet Million Hybrid Tomatoes, F1. The plant produces heavy yields of 1-inch red cherry tomatoes, very sweet. And in the row next door here, they're growing Tomatoes Roma VF, and the classic Italian paste tomato, bright red, plum-shaped paste-type fruits with meaty interiors. So you can see here, here's the baby tomato plants growing. They got all in a drip system using P-tape with drippers coming out, and here's the tomatoes, and look at these. I mean, look at these nice babies. They're gonna be ripe probably within another 30 days. The Roma tomatoes, they're growing here at Gilcrease. Another variety they're growing here is a Celebrity Hybrid Tomato. It's an All-American winner. Determinant plants, crack-resistant fruits, average of 7 ounces. So what determinant means is that they'll grow for a predetermined amount of time, and then they're going to end their life cycle. So they're going to stop basically putting on fruit. So in most cases, I recommend, unless you have a short season or some other reason to grow the determinants, like maybe they do well here in Las Vegas, and a short season is better than no season, you know, to grow the determinant. I like to grow the indeterminate varieties that just literally keep growing until there's a frost and will keep pumping out fresh and ripe homegrown tomatoes for you to eat at home. So they're also growing the tomatillos, Toma Verde variety. Tomatillos have a sweet, tangy flavor, essential for authentic sauces and many Southwestern dishes. Fruits the size of a small tomato are green when ripe and are encased in a papery husks. Okay, so I'd probably change that from being green when ripe. They can be green when they're ripe, but actually they get a nice yellowish color or purplish color when they're totally ripe and the paper will start to split off them. When they get riper, they definitely get sweeter, and if they're not as ripe, they're gonna be more tart. So depending on what kind of flavor you wanna use in your recipe, you might wanna pick a more unripe if you want that kind of sourish, tart flavor. But if you want them sweet, and I usually only eat my tomatillos sweet, you wanna get them when the paper's kind of cracking. It's kind of a yellowish color instead of a green, or some varieties of tomatillos are purple, and sometimes actually the fruit cracks. You got to remove the husk, and you know they're actually super delicious when they're ripe, and most people haven't had a ripe tomatillo. Here they are here in the rows. They're growing really well. It's pretty much in the tomato family, and you can see it's flowering now. So these are the flowers that will turn into the fruits, and we'll look forward here to eating some tomatillos from Gilcrease pretty soon. Another thing that they must be doing really well, that must grow well here in the desert, is the Oriental eggplants. These Asian eggplants have a thick skin and a sweet, delicate flavor. You can see the row here behind me of the eggplants. They're also in the tomato family, or Solanaceae family, along with the tomatillos next door. They're gonna be coming on pretty soon. And you know, there's all different varieties of eggplants, you know, ones from Italy and ones from Asia, and each one tastes a little bit different. There's white eggplants, Japanese eggplants. I got purple white variety from Italy that I'm gonna be growing. But you know, I think I like the Asian eggplants better. The Japanese and the white eggplants are my two favorite eggplants. So in the desert here, definitely could grow the Asian eggplants, the Oriental eggplants. Maybe they do better here in this climate. So once again, we wanna get plants that are better climatized for your climate where you're growing, because then it's just easier to grow. You're not gonna have to struggle as hard with it. If you're trying to grow something that doesn't naturally grow in the desert, you're gonna have to really fight hard to make it work. But we wanna make gardening easy, and make gardening easy by growing the things that'll do best in your climate. So what else are they growing at Gilcrease besides the tomatoes? They're growing melons, and these are called Burrell's Jumbo Cantaloupe, a very delicious old variety from the D.V. Burrell Seed Company. Large netted melons weigh up to 5 pounds and have extremely thick, sweet, flavorful, salmon-colored flesh. So looks like they just planted them. They're really small. They're still gonna take a little bit of time to be ripe and ready for you to eat. But it's really important, you know, when you're growing in your own home environment and climate, every climate's a little different, and certain seeds and plants have naturalized for certain climate areas. So maybe this variety does better in hot climates that are kind of dry, like here in Las Vegas. So I encourage everybody to, you know, find seeds that are good for your climate and your environment. One of the cucumbers that really does well here at Gilcrease, based on past visits here to Gilcrease, is the Armenian cucumbers. So Armenian cucumbers, guess where they're from? Probably Armenia, and it's probably hot, really hot over there. So they do really well here in the desert. They grow to be super big. So one of the best tasting salad slices, a long rib, pale green fruit, so tender it doesn't need peeling. Best harvest, 12 inches to 24 inches, still good at 36 inches. Good pickling with this snake melon. So actually these get so big, and when they get really big, I like to juice them. We could take a look here. They're just letting these vine out on the ground instead of trellising them up like I do, because they have lots of space here. They probably planted them out about every 2 feet, and you can see the vines on this, man. I mean, it's incredible, and you can see all the flowers growing, and if we look probably really hard, we might be able to see some baby cucumbers starting, but I don't see any on there right now. Let's move on and see what else is growing here at Gilcrease Orchards. So here's the acorn squash they're growing, and this is a winter squash. So the winter squashes are different than the summer squashes. The winter squashes basically have hard skins, and basically you harvest the winter squashes at the end of summer, and then they'll keep through the winter. Actually, I just ate an acorn squash that I grew last summer, just about a week ago, actually. We opened it up. So they'll save for the winter. That's why they're called winter squashes. This is an acorn squash, winter type squash, deep ribbed acorn shaped fruit, flesh is orange. And if you're gonna do a home gardening squash for winter squash, I recommend growing something like a butternut squash is really good, or even a banana squash. Those are actually two of my favorite squashes. Also here at Gilcrease, they're growing summer Seneca zucchini squash, and this is one of the earliest summer squashes with outstanding flavor and small seed cavity. The dark green fruit should be picked when 6 to 8 inches long and 1.5 to 2 inches in diameter. Heavy yields are characteristic throughout the long harvest period. So summer squash are definitely good. I like to spiralize my summer squashes. They're one of the fastest and most prolific plants to grow. If you want to grow like one summer vegetable, all you need is like one zucchini plant, and it'll put out a mass of fruits to eat. So let's go over here and harvest one. So you can see the beautiful zucchini flowers, and you know these flowers are edible. Many high-end restaurants will actually use these. They'll stuff these flowers, but you know what? You could also eat the flowers raw. Let's see if we can find, okay, here's a nice zucchini here. So as you can see, each one of these flowers, you know, many of them turn into the fruit. So here's a flower, and here's the small fruit. Here's, you know, a zucchini here, here, here. I mean, there's at least almost a half dozen fruits on this. We're gonna go ahead and harvest this zucchini. When you grow it at home, you get to choose when you want to harvest it, you know, whether you want to harvest them young or when they're older. I definitely like my zucchini younger. They're more tender and definitely more flavorful. If they get bigger, the seeds get a lot harder, and you know, the meat, the flesh inside gets kind of spongy. So harvest your zucchini younger for best taste. They're also growing okra Clemson spineless here at the Gilcrease Orchard. It's a extra long, dark green, meaty pods with full-bodied flavor. So you can see the okra growing. They've just planted it out, and hopefully they'll have some okra growing here in Las Vegas. I look forward to that. Now you can see here at Gilcrease, they just planted out a brand new orchard of fig trees. I love fig trees, and yes, you could grow fig trees in the desert. Here in the desert, one of the best things to grow is actually trees. They're more resistant to the desert environment. As long as you feed them enough water, they'll do all right. What we're looking at is a brand new row of pomegranate trees that they've just planted out. They'll probably be ready in a couple years here. And you can see they basically make a line. So to put things in rows, they have stakes. About every 100 feet, they have a stake down, and they have the string to keep everything in a straight row. And they have a water piped basically to each tree. It'll probably be definitely a couple more years till the pomegranates are ready. But pomegranates are actually an excellent fruit, excellent backyard fruit tree to have here in Las Vegas. They do really, really well. So we're in the middle of the Gilcrease Orchard here. Many of the trees are planted in rows on
wire to kind of make it easier for picking, but then they have a free form orchard here, and this is just one of the free form orchard trees. They kind of don't prune these back as hard as the ones that are growing basically on the trellises. So this is an apricot tree here. I picked a whole bunch of apricots. They're so good. And then over here, you know, later in the season, they're going to have some apples. And I mean, look at this tree. It's freaking loaded with apples. And, you know, believe it or not, we're here in the middle of Las Vegas, Nevada, where people come to gamble and think of it as Sin City. But you know what? You could grow food in Las Vegas. And I encourage more people to grow more food in Las Vegas in the desert, because you know what? We all need to take responsibility for ourselves. We leave what is grown up to farmers and up to seed companies. When you grow your own food, you get to choose what you want to grow in your front yard, your backyard, and on your patio, in containers, or even sprouting in your own kitchen. So this is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time.